from Plain Sailing, based at Duxford in Cambridgeshire, the consolidated PBY-5A Catalina. PBY-5A model that we see here added the tricycle undercarriage. These aircraft were built not just by Consolidated itself, but also Canadian Vickers as the Canso, by Boeing in both the United States and Canada, and the US Naval Aircraft Factory, plus in the USSR. And that was for a total of just over 4,050 Catalinas, Cansos, and Soviet GSTs that rolled off the various production lines between 1937 and 45. As far as the Royal Air Force was concerned, the Catalina was crucial in bridging the so-called U-boat gap in the North Atlantic. In that area, German submarines were able to roam at one stage almost at will, supported by the Luftwaffe's Focke-Wulf FW-200 Condor maritime aircraft. It was an area out of range of existing Allied land-based aircrafts. It posed a serious threat to the supply convoys across the North Atlantic that were so vital in keeping supplies heading to Britain during World War II. The RAF ordered a first batch of 50 Catalinas around the outbreak of war in 1939, followed by many more, reaching a total in the end of around 570. All of our few Mark IIIs were pure Catalinas given to RAF service with units stationed in Northern Ireland in 1941. Here, incidentally, you can see the wingtip floats being extended on this orbit. This May in 1941, that RAF Catalinas achieved really their first high profile operational success when they sighted the German battleship Bismarck. In 1944, two Coastal Command Catalina pilots were awarded the Victoria Cross. One was Flying Officer John Cruikshank, No. 210 Squadron, the other a Canadian, Flight Lieutenant David Hornell of No. 162 Squadron, both for pressing home attacks against German U boats while under heavy enemy fire. Rescue duties during the Second World War. airframe that it depicts was in service in early 1945 with the 5th Emergency Rescue Squadron, stationed at Halesworth in Suffolk. On the 30th of March that year, the aircraft, which bears the name Dragamoot, landed on the water while engaged in a sortie looking for the pilot of a P-51 Mustang that had ditched in the sea. But the Catalina was unable to take off again because of a dead starboard engine. It taxied on the water for 90 minutes to get away from the Dutch coast. At midday the following day, the aircraft was shot up by Messerschmitt Mi-262 jet fighters, and its crew had to abandon it. They took to dinghies on the 31st of March. They weren't rescued again until the 4th of April. Of Saskatchewan. Circumnavigation of the UK over 3,300 kilometres in an airborne time of just over 18 hours over the course of 4 days. So coming in now to land with tricycle undercarriage once again extended.
I know, I was just thinking that everyone's clearing up now, look.
The aircraft will incidentally be doing quite a quick turnaround, picking up the ground crew having landed and then heading straight back off to its home base at Duxford. So in low over the threshold, courtesy of plain sailing, the consolidated PBY-5A Catalina. Captaining the aircraft today, Derek Head. He's a former Royal Air Force pilot on the Andover and Hercules transport aircraft, who's just retired from flying for Thomson Fly on the Boeing 737. And the co-pilot for today's display, Matt Dearden, has actually just upgraded to captain on the aircraft in the last few months. Matt works as a PC-6 turboporter pilot out in Papua New Guinea as his day job, and you can follow his adventures on Twitter where he is at IndoPilot.
What?
Displayed by Derek and Matt in typically stately fashion, and what a beautiful way to end an excellent day of 2016 at the Air Show. Thank you so much. Once again, I stress that the sun is a little bit of rain.
update myself on by visits to the website. A couple of those that I would particularly flag up, things that are making their way from the aircraft park down at the left-hand end of the airfield. Now seems like a time to bid you farewell, so for the whole team.